Simplifying Radicals by Alison Hammack. We're going to start off today with simplifying completely this radical expression. So what we want to do is we want to make a factor tree of our 9 here. So 9 is 3 times 3. And then x will be just x. And y squared will be y times y. So we want to rewrite this underneath the radical. So let's just rewrite it over here with the radical symbol over top of it. And now what we're going to do is we're going to cross out the pairs. Because for every pair underneath the square root sign or radical sign, one of the pairs comes out of the radical. So here, 3 and 3, the 3 comes out. X only has himself, so we leave him under there. Y, for every pair, 1 comes out. So now the things that are on the outside get multiplied together, and we're left with 3 times y square root x is the only thing left under, so square root of x. And that problem's done. Okay, problem number 2, we're asked to simplify square root of 50 times y to the third. So let's work on the 50 first. Let's make a factor tree of 50. Well, 50 is 5 times 10. 5 is already a prime number. There's only 1 in itself, so we don't want to go further. But 10 is 5 times 2. Y is going to be y times y times y. So let's rewrite these factors underneath a square root symbol. We have 2 times 5 times 5 times y times y times y. And now let's pull the pairs out and then we'll be done. So the 5's are a pair, 1 comes out. The y's are a pair, 1 comes out. So now on the outside we're left with 5 times y times the square root of 2 and y. And this problem is done. So let's try number 3. Well, let's do one without a coefficient. Xy to the 4th times the square root of x to the 10, y. Okay? So this portion is already outside the radical, so it's the inside part that we need to work on simplifying. X to the 10th, well, we can rewrite this. Let's rewrite the problem. Leave the outside. X to the 10th can be expanded. We can make 10 x's here. There's 10 and a y. So now for every pair, one of the pairs will come out of the radical. So we cross out our pairs and we bring one of the pairs out. So you notice that this was an even number, x to the 10, and we had 5 x's come out. So now all the things on the outside get multiplied together. So let's put our answer down here. How many x's are now on the outside? Well, there's 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. So that is x to the 6, y to the 4, times the square root of just y. And that problem is done. Okay, our fourth problem, 3y times the square root of 98x to the 4th, y to the 5th. So the first item I want to do is I want to break out 98 into its factor tree. Well, 98, I'm not sure right off what divides into 98, but because it's an 8, I know that it's an even number, and so 2 will divide by this. So over on the side somewhere, I'm going to do 98 divided by 2 to see what we will get. And it looks like we get 49. So we have 2 times 49. And now 49 we can break into its factors. 7 times 7. So now let's go ahead and rewrite this expression up here. I'll put it down here below. So we have 3y times the square root. And let's list the prime factorization for 98. So that's 2. We list these least to greatest, and we want to list them together, the pairs together. Okay, that's a times. And then let's go ahead and expand this part. We're going to expand this portion here. Let's put it down under here. So x to the 4th, we have 4 x's. y to the fifth, we will have five y's. 4 and 5. So now we're going to take out the pairs. So we remove pairs. Okay? So for every pair, one comes out. So we cross out the 7, bring the 7 out. One of the x's, another x, a y, and one more y. Now, this 2 did not have a pair, so he could not come out of the square root symbol. This y did not have a pair, so he could not come out. So now we're going to multiply together. We're going to multiply all these things that are on the outside here together, and then rewrite them down below. So we have 3 times 7, that's 21. And then we have how many x's? 2 x's, so we'll have x squared. How many y's do we have? 1, 2, 3. So that's y cubed times the square root. There's a 2 left under, so we need a 2 there. And a y got left under. So here's our answer for this problem. Okay, example 5, we're going to simplify this expression completely. Notice that we have a parenthesis and we have some radical math to do here in the inside. So let's start with the inside because Jem Doss always tells us to start with the inside. So we need to simplify this radical. So square root of 8, we can think of it as 4 times 2. Square root of 4, or I'm sorry, the factors for 4 are 2 times 2. So 3 is just 3 times 1. So because it's 3 times 1, we're not going to make a factor tree for it. So let's rewrite this now. Recognize that this is also the same as this one here. So we can have the same exact factor tree for that one. So let us rewrite the problem, expand it out. So here we're going to have the prime factors, 2 times 2 times 2. Times the quantity square root of 3 plus the square root of the prime factors, 4, 8. 2 times 2 times 2. So let's simplify this, taking out the pair here. So on this inside portion, we get square root of 3 plus 2, the square root of 2. Now, we cannot add these, because they do not have the same radical. We do not have the same number underneath the radical sign. So what we're going to do, well, let's finish this side here. Here, square root of 2, take out a 2, so here we're left with 2 square root of 2. So since we cannot add these, we're going to have to distribute. We're going to distribute this through to here. So we have to distribute. So the things on the outside stay out, so we get 2. Square root of 2 times 3 is 6, plus 2 times 2 is 4. Square root of 2 times 2, well, let's write it out like this, because we see we have a pair here. So we want to go ahead and simplify this further, bring that 2 out. So here we have 2 square root of 6 plus 4 times 2 is 8. This is our final answer in this. Now, you may ask, well, why didn't I simplify the square root of 6? Well, square root of 6 is 3 times 2. There are no pairs in here, so it doesn't simplify any further. So we stop there and don't use this. Okay, so our last problem here, we look here and we want to do this math first. The square roots do not match each other. 5 has only 5 times 1 as the prime number. 6 only has 6, or 2 times 3. So we cannot make factor trees for these. So the only thing we're left to do is distribute. So we're going to distribute this to this term here. So we have 3 times 2, and that is 6. We have square root of 3 times the square root of 5, so that's square root of 15. Now we keep our symbol, plus 3 times, there's, think of it like a 1 there. 3 times 1 is 3. And now square root of 3 times the square root of 6 is the square root of 18. So now we have to simplify this further. Simplify further if possible. So 15, its factors are 5 times 3. We cannot make anything further. These are prime numbers, so they do not factor further. 18, on the other hand, we could say is 9 times 2, and 9 is 3 times 3. So we cannot change this square root, but we can expand this one. So let's rewrite it. It's 3 square root of its prime factors listed least to greatest, 2 times 3 times 3. Take out the pair. Rewrite it. This side didn't change. 3 times 3 is 9. Square root of 2. So we can't go any further. This is our answer.